Hello students, this is from TK Jain School. Let's start the debate. Then there is a state monopoly. Natural monopolies are those which are given by the creator of the world. That by nature. State monopoly means certain state or certain powers that they have. For example, the central government has a power to control the railways, defense and other few industries. No one can come and interfere in this, which means the central government has a railways, they will fix the price, they will fix everything. No one can say, I will have my own railways and run on the road. No, it's not possible. So state monopoly. Next, legal monopoly. Likewise, legal monopolies are those monopoly where you have the legal rights over certain patents, on certain logos, certain designs, certain ideas, certain ideology, certain designs, certain things, certain positivity, certain philosophy. So when you have rights on certain thing that differs from others that no one has. For example, Apple industry. The iPhone industry has a logo of Apple. The Apple that has cut. That is logo. If he wants to sell it, he can sell it. Isn't it? He has a full right to sell the logo. And he is the monopoly person. Because he is going to sell his trademark, his logo, his design, his hard work. He can fix the price of whatever he wants. Legal monopoly. Natural monopoly given by the Almighty. A natural resource. State monopoly fixed by any government. Legal monopoly. You have certain item, on that you can have a legal monopoly. Price determination. On what basis? On what basis that the price can be fixed? See student, price determination plays a vital role and they can be divided into three aspects: personal, geographical, on the basis of it. In the personal, different prices are charged for different individual. What happened here? Different prices are charged for different individual. So, for me, a different price. For other, a different price. How? Take example of Indian Railways. For senior citizen, there is a concession. If I am paying 800 rupees for a second class, senior citizen pay 500. 300 discount for a senior citizen. So, based on the person, based on the gender, based on the age, based on the criteria, based on the profession, some price is fixed. That is what we call personal price distribution. Geographical. Based on the area aspect, so different place is the reason for changing up. How? In India, if you take a rate of a book, for example, 50 rupees, the same book in China you get for 30 rupees. So based on the geographical area, the price changes. The price is fixed on the basis of use. So how much you are using the things? How much you are using the product or commodities or service? On the basis of that also it gets segregated. I am, as an Indian, using more dal per pulse. I am using more sambar, I am eating more sambar, more vegetables than the non-vegetarian things. That is the Indian heritage. That is the use. So what the monopolistic market will do? They will try to sell the more vegetable aspect, the more vegetable things, the more vegetarian aspect, because they know that in India there is a, this is in use. There is a three different examples I would like to give you. There is a church. Near the church, what shop you should have? You should have a church, you should have a shop of a candle. Near a temple, you should have a diya and the oil or the flowers. Near the mosque, what should you have? Or near the dargah, what should you have? You should have bigger beds, right? A big shawl, a design shawl. What this it says means where and what is used, where what is where needed, that we have to use. That we should take. In the place of church, the candle is in use and I will go and sell the crackers over there. That is a useless thing.
In the season of Deepavali, I am going to sell the colors. That is a stupid thing. So, on the basis of use also, the monopolistic market gets fixed. Next one, we have to identify how this price determines the output. Price output determination and the monopoly. How? We have took the example of quantity as x axis, price as a y axis. Average revenue falling down. Because the average revenue is falling down, marginal revenue falls below the area. Whenever average revenue falls down, marginal revenue will fall below the average. Easy? Average cost is in U shape, same marginal cost in U shape above the average curve. Average curve is in U shape and the marginal curve is also U shape and it is above the average curve. It is above. The meeting point of marginal revenue and the marginal cost is what equilibrium. So when the MR is as equal to MC, that is what the equilibrium is. MR is equal to marginal revenue is equal to marginal cost, that is what you are receiving the maximum satisfaction. And this area is a perfect. This area is an abnormal profit. And apart from this is a loss. How? When there is a maximum satisfaction of equilibrium, till here it's a profit. Above that, it's an abnormal profit. If it's going above the average revenue, then will be a loss. So when there is a perfect combination of average revenue and average cost, marginal revenue and marginal cost, there you are enjoying the maximum profit. Apart from that, abnormal profit, if anything goes above that, that is a loss. So this is the concept of monopoly market, where there is a single seller and he sells everything. He is a decider of price, he is a decider of market, he is a decider of product, he is a decider of buyer. If he wants, he decides everything because he is the creator of the product, hence he has the right and thing to do whatever he wants to. In our future class, we'll see the next parts of imperfect competition like duopoly, monopolistic competition, bilateral competition and many more things. Thank you, students.